and welcome to a Business Minute with Lily Lopez, presented by the South Florida Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, bringing this show straight from Honolulu, Hawaii, one of the most beautiful islands in the world. And stay tuned as we will be speaking shortly to the President and CEO of the Hawaii Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, Barbara De Luca.
Aloha! Aloha, Barbara Salazar De Luca!
Aloha!
Welcome to a Business Minute with Lily Lopez, presented by the South Florida Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. Wow, beautiful Hawaii.
Yes.
Was there, loved it. We went to Maui, Honolulu, and just, I mean, I thought it was like Miami Beach, but nothing like Miami. I mean, my city's beautiful.
It is.
You say it, but Honolulu and Maui is just one of the most beautiful places I've seen in the world, and I travel. So, So it's such a pleasure, Barbara, to have you.
Did you do the road? Sorry. Did you do the road to Hana?
Yes, the road to Hana, the volcano.
The volcano Haleakala.
Yay!
Yes.
It's beautiful. So, Barbara Salazar De Luca, president of the Hispanic Chamber of Hawaii. So tell me, how did this Hispanic Chamber come about? I know you're fifth generation Hispanic.
Sí.
How's the population, the percentages of Hispanics in all the islands?
Okay, well, as of the last census 10 years ago, we had 142,000 Hispanics across the islands. And that was 10 years ago. So we just participated in the new census with the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and we'll find out those results around April. So it should be interesting, the breakdown.
Absolutely. Yes. Yeah. And so, the majority of, like, I know there's Puerto Rican Americans. How about Mexicans?
Yes.
The majority of Mexican Americans?
There's both. You know, I have an article right here in front of me. So if my eyes go over here, this is from, our Circle Gate in Honolulu. But anyhow, it's an article on the Hispanics and how we made our way here with the first pineapple crops and the Hawaiian Islands and the sugar plantations and the sugar cane fields. So that brought a lot of the Hispanic population over. We currently still produce pineapples, but no longer sugarcane. And then the Puerto Ricans moved out in the 1900s to the plantations. And, you know, the Hispanics, we introduced the cowboy culture to Hawaii also, the paniolos. That's what they call them in Hawaii.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Were you born? You're born in Hawaii?
No, you would think I was, huh?
Right.
I'm from Arizona.
Ada, how was it? You taught me to do this over there.
my children are born here now. Sorry, my children are born here now. I moved here in 1999.
And you love it, obviously.
Yes, it's my second home. Even though I just traveled home to Arizona for the holidays, that's how come we missed each other. You were here while I was in Arizona, and when I came back, you were leaving.
I know, but I did my opening there in a beautiful luau, and so we're doing this now, and it's perfect.
Right.
I'm just so thrilled to meet you and to have met also Marisol Ruiz, who's your VP. And but so tell me a little about the chamber. It's about 1 year old, right, already?
Yes, it is. So let's see here. I got into real estate as a broker in 2015 here on the islands.
Right.
And I was thinking, you know, I was talking to Marisol Ruiz, who's also a lender, so we work in the same industry.
Right.
And we were like, we should join the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce to network and expand our business, and it didn't exist. It did 10 years prior. So we connected with the president that had run it 10 years prior, and she helped us get organized. Her name's Mari Villa, and she has she helps small businesses. She's a grant writer.
Okay. So
she was able to get us established as a 501c3, which is great because there's not that many Hispanic chambers in the country.
I imagine.
That are nonprofit. So
right.
Great opportunity. So anyhow, we established in 2019, and we just celebrated 1 year September 2019. Wow. 2020,
sorry. You're right. And then what type of services do you provide to the members, to your members?
Well, right now we have done a lot of webinars since
Starting September,
right? So around, we got a couple of great events off of the, January, February, March, some how to start a small business seminar, a mixer, some things like that. And then COVID hit like it did all of us. But we've been able to provide information to the public. One of our board members was he's an immigration attorney. He lives on Maui. So he was able to give a webinar on immigration and so forth.
Of course, we have had to pivot as well, but we're
we have done live events. Because Miami's not closed completely, it isn't. So we've been able to do some live events, of course, with a lot of precaution, you know, social distancing and the sanitizing and all of that. But at the same time, we've done a lot of webinars just like you have.
We need to talk about your luncheons. I was looking at your website, and I would love to do luncheons maybe twice or three times a year, just to grow that membership. Yeah, I can tell you about our board members. As you know, Marisol Ruiz is our vice president, and then we brought in Monica Nunez, and she is our secretary. She's also a 14-year Navy veteran. So she moved here from LA. And we also have Ruben Juarez. He's our treasurer. I believe he's from Mexico City. I hope I'm getting this right. And he is a professor at the University of Hawaii in economics. So he's the one that handled our money. lots of great people on our board. Juan Cruz, he came over from the Bronx. He's Puerto Rican. So a good mix.
Oh, I like Puerto Ricans.
Yes.
Puerto Ricans. And you basically represent all the islands. So will we doing events later on in other islands? I mean, I think it would be so fabulous.
Oh, yes, for sure.
In the world, so you could probably host events and just take an airplane and take your group and your members so they can meet other members from the other islands, right?
Right. Great. When we were working with the census and reaching out to outer islands, we got to meet some other business owners that have joined the chamber and made those connections. So yeah, it's going to be great.
It's wonderful.
Yeah.
So happy. I'm so happy to connect with you. And so is there anything else that we're missing that you would like to add regarding the Hawaii Hispanic Chamber? I was just thrilled to know that there was a Hawaii Hispanic Chamber. I love it. Because we founded our chamber 26 years ago, out of necessity and need that we saw. And that's what you guys are doing. You guys are being a pioneer. And
yes.
I think it's wonderful. And I salute you and all of your board members for doing such a great job and trying to outreach and help Hispanic businesses in Hawaii. And I didn't even have an idea that I knew there was like 100,000 Hispanics, but you say it's like 150,000 Hispanics.
Correct.
That's a lot.
And I'm sure there's going to be a lot more.
And I want to go back.
Oh, yes.
We'll do a trade mission. To my members, if I say that we're doing something like that, that we'll go over there. Absolutely.
Oh, for sure. I would love to host you guys.
Oh, yes.
So how has COVID affected your tourism industry since we have similar?
Yes, similar. Exactly. It has affected it tremendously in an adverse way, of course, because we're the number one, the cruise capital of the world. So there's no cruises. So imagine that. And and the airport also has been affected tremendously. I don't know if it's as bad as Hawaii, because the governor here is a little bit more maybe lenient. And and then we applaud that, because if not, we depend strictly on, I mean, mostly, we're a tourist state. I mean, hospitality, state. So had he closed everything down completely, like restaurants, for a while, they were closed for 3 months and four months. And I remember that we were the number one chamber talking about that on radio, and we did a petition and trying to get everybody to sign it so that they would open restaurants, because it got to a point, Barbara, there was a lot of unemployment, a lot of people losing their businesses. So in reality, we've been able, with the governor and everything, to sort of open, keep the numbers. I mean, the numbers have been high, but not that bad, like California nor New York. So in reality, at least it's bad, but not as bad, right? I mean, it's good. It's bad because not a lot of people are traveling, but it's not as bad as it was in the summer. So for us, but we really do need that industry to get up and running again, especially the cruise line industry, because that, you know, it trickles down. I mean, you know, the taxis, you know, the hotels, it's bad.
And restaurants.
Restaurants, we depend. I mean, the bus, buses and all those tours.
Same here. I can discuss how it's affected Hawaii also.
Yeah, tell me, please. Yes, our members would want to know.
Yeah, same thing. The tourism industry is about 20% of our income here. And thankfully, we have the military, which is produces a lot of jobs and income here.
So how is that only 20%? I thought it was more.
Yeah, no, tourism is about 20-25%. So before COVID hit, we were getting about 40,000 tourists in the Oahu a day. Okay. And then when we shut down in March, it went down to about, it trickled down like 3,000. Like you can count the people here, and they had to come in on lockdown. It was very strict, but that's how they've kept the COVID rate, infection rate so low. We've been about 2-3%, and 300 is high for us.
Right.
Right. On a day.
Percent here is like 8% now. Mm-hmm. I think, but it's not that bad considering. Yeah.
That's not bad.
Yeah, because the population in Miami-Dade County is close to 3 million, like 2.
Exactly. Yeah.
So that bad. That's what I say. For being a big metropolitan area, Miami-Dade County, we're not doing that bad. So yeah. I really applaud the mayor, our mayor, Kevin Cava, and our governor, because they've been working together. And so it's been relatively okay. I mean, everybody's trying to be very safe because we want our economy to grow. And let's see what happens, right? I mean, we're just praying that this will go away. And with the vaccine and everything will start to go back to normal slowly.
Right. Yeah. Right. December 15th, we actually opened up our economy back, to more tourism in. So like the Hilton Hawaiian just opened December 15th. They've been closed since March.
Yes. That's what we say. Now when we're
Oh, really?
Waikiki, the one in Waikiki Beach.
Uh-huh. Oh, nice.
And I mean, everything that I saw over there was fantastic. And I see in your face, and also in Marisol's face, the nice Hawaiian hospitality. Hispanic Hawaiian. That's right. A good combination. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that.
It doesn't. Yes, the aloha. We share the aloha spirit, and it's just like the Hispanic culture.
Oh, yes. So thank you, Barbara. Thank you so very much. And we'll be connecting with you soon to see
how it's
better. Absolutely. So thank you for being on a Business Minute with Lily Lopez, and that's presented by our South Florida Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and looking forward to continue with this partnership. Aloha.
Nice talking to you, Lillian. Thank you.
Likewise.
Okay. Aloha.
Aloha.